Hello, my name is Michael Urbano. I'm with the Chicago Audio Collective. I've been restoring and repairing guitar amplifiers since about 1978. And today we're going to demonstrate a Fender Super Reverb, and we have a special guest to help us, Josh Siegel of Bailiff, a band that plays pretty regularly in the area. Josh, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself and about the guitar you're going to use?
Let's see, I've been playing guitar for, 15 years. I'm now the guitarist in Bailiff, and we are in... The whole band lives in this compound, and we're in our rehearsal spot. Using the guitar that I always use, it's a 1962 reissue from 1987. The only changes I've made are putting jumbo frets on and bigger strings to get a fatter sound. I like the way acoustic guitars feel, so it feels kind of like that. And this is the amp I always use too. It's been going strong for the 10 years that I've owned it.
It's a 1966 Fender Super Reverb with four tens. It's sort of the guitar version of the famous Fender Bassman with the Oxblood grill cover, as you can see. It's relatively unmodified. It has some Mojo M10RR speakers in place of its original Jensens. But other than that, pretty standard issue. It's been extensively repaired and worked on because Josh uses it pretty regularly, as he said, for many years. It's his number one amp for both on stage and in the studio. And we're going to give it a try, let you hear it clean and in a few other ways. This is a Heathkit TA-28 distortion booster pedal. It was sold from about 1971 to about 1978. This one's about 72 era. What's interesting about it is it was sold as a kit. You assembled it from individual component parts. It has a permanently attached output cord, which is unique to that era, a level control, which controls the amount of fuzz, and a tone control, pretty self-explanatory. And Josh is going to help us hear what it sounds like. This is an interesting pedal that I most recently serviced. It's an MXR Phase 90, and it is from the first series, which has the Script logo. This one dates from about 1971 and had some problems. They've all been sorted out, and it's a very popular phase shifter, especially with Eddie Van Halen, as research tells me. So we're going to let Josh give it a try. here is a Foxey Lady fuzz pedal that I recently repaired. It's from about 1968 and has a pretty aggressive fuzz sound. Has an on-off switch, of course the foot switch, as you can see. It has a volume control that's used to equalize the sound between the clean sound and the fuzz sound, and a control marked fuzz, which is more of a tone control, and Josh is going to help us hear what it sounds like.